Hey guys, this is a tutorial on how to use a MIDI controller with GarageBand specifically. And this is actually a snippet from a larger, more extensive GarageBand tutorial that I have. It's completely for free and it's on YouTube as well. I'll leave that in the description if you're looking for a more full-scale GarageBand course from start to finish. Most things you need to know for the beginner. So if you're interested, check that out below. But let's get into this video on how to use a MIDI controller with GarageBand. A MIDI controller is just kind of, it looks like a keyboard, but it's not actually a keyboard. For example, I have my MIDI controller right here and I'll put up an image on the screen just so you can see what it looks like. A MIDI controller's purpose is to actually play the sounds of the instrument you choose in your digital audio workstation or GarageBand, for instance. For example, if we have a MIDI controller and choose piano, we can go and actually just press the keys on our controller and it will use the sounds that GarageBand gives us. The same thing, it doesn't actually have to be a piano sound. If we want to play a drum kit and we go to drum kit and we put in Brooklyn, we can use the same MIDI controller and press the keys on our MIDI controller and it will sound like a drum. For example, I can do that right now. It has Brooklyn track here, that's a drum set. And I can go over to my MIDI controller and just press on it to find where the drum sounds are. And that's a tom. That's a kick. That's a snare. And I can just record right now by just clicking R and recording some sounds. So that's how you would actually do that. We're going to keep moving and we'll dive into the recording in a little bit. If you have a MIDI keyboard, then what you're going to want to do is it's likely USB input, so just plug it in to your put the cord into your MIDI keyboard and then plug it into your computer. And GarageBand is smart enough to recognize that, hey, you've plugged in a MIDI controller, so I'm just going to work automatically for you. And so it will just work. If that doesn't happen, no worries. Go up to GarageBand preferences and go to audio MIDI. And here you'll see MIDI and you'll see MIDI status, 2 MIDI inputs detected. And if it says 0 MIDI inputs detected, you can reset the MIDI drivers and that will kind of refresh the scan. But most of the time, GarageBand, pretty much all the time, will recognize that you've plugged that in and will automatically work that out for you.